By the end of this video, you'll know the answers to these common questions. Can the scope of a sprint be changed within a sprint? Can the sprint goal of a sprint be changed during the sprint? Can we add stories, tasks while the sprint is running? Can the sprint backlog be changed? I get these questions a lot. Everyone is sort of confused, a bit confused on what is allowed or not with regards to work once the sprint has started. But first off, if you don't know what Agile Scrum is, watch this video. I did a full breakdown of Agile Scrum with a good analogy. You can just watch it after this video. I don't know if you've noticed, but all these questions revolve around a single thing. Well, two things, the sprint goal and the sprint backlog. Let's start with the sprint backlog, which is quite simple. Basically, it's a list of things, product, backlog, items that the team have committed to work on within a sprint. It also contains a plan, a detailed plan on how to work on how to complete all these product backlog items within the sprint to meet the sprint goal. Really important to meet the sprint goal. Basically, all the development team needs to work to create features, to develop features, to do anything is in the sprint backlog. All the product backlog items in the sprint backlog, stories, tasks, defects, improvement items from past retrospectives, all of these selected for the sprint in the sprint backlog. Now, extremely important, there shouldn't be anything that the development team is working on during a sprint which is not in the sprint backlog. Remember this. This is extremely important. We'll talk about this later. But remember this for now. Next, move on to the sprint goal. As per the Scrum Guide 2020, the sprint goal is a single objective that the team has within a sprint. Even though the sprint goal is a commitment by the team, it's quite flexible in terms of the exact work needed to achieve it. The sprint goal decided during the sprint planning. The team will commit on the sprint goal during the sprint planning, and the sprint goal will be added to the sprint backlog. As the developers work during a sprint, they always keep their mind and focus on the sprint goal. At any point in time, if they feel that what we need to do to achieve this sprint goal as a team is quite different from what we expected, we work with a product owner. The team works together and decides together how to change and alter the sprint backlog without affecting the sprint goal. Extremely important. The sprint backlog can change and be altered. That's the work. But the sprint goal, the single objective of the team, cannot be altered. With all this in mind, let's take a typical scenario. A scenario that happens very often. Within a sprint, the sprint has already started, and we realize that there's an important item, extremely important item, a feature that needs to be developed, which we didn't know prior. When we started the sprint, in the sprint planning, the team didn't commit to do that, just cropped up, just became high priority. And we realize also that other items have been deprioritized, no longer needed. What do we do? Remember the core premise of Scrum. We can't create detailed plans for the future, even if the future means a single sprint. So it's entirely possible that the product owner might get new insights within a sprint. New impediments, technical impediments, will block us from achieving what we committed on. It's entirely possible. So what do we do when these things happen, when new priorities happen? New things become top priority and other things become low priority within a sprint. While the development team and the product owner together can decide what needs to be changed in the sprint backlog to reflect all these insights, impediments, change in priorities and all that. But without changing the sprint goal, the focus, the laser focus should be on the sprint goal. You can do anything you want with a sprint backlog, and you need to do it because the development team will constantly be changing stuff within a sprint to the sprint backlog, adding things to stories, altering other stories, adding new tasks and all that. But don't alter, don't change the sprint goal. And remember, the sprint backlog is owned by the development team, not the product owner. The product owner owns the product backlog. with a sprint backlog owned by the development team. Don't let the product owners or product owner bully you into changing the sprint backlog or the sprint goal. Nope. Owned by the development team. You have a full right to do whatever you want with a sprint backlog. Now, what happens if a sprint backlog has changed so much but the sprint goal no longer makes any sense? Achieving the items in the sprint backlog will not result in achieving the sprint goals because they are so different. The sprint backlog has changed so much. We already talked about that. You can change the sprint backlog, but you cannot change the sprint goal within the sprint. And there's a reason for that. If you let the team do whatever they want, you can change the sprint goal within a sprint. This will cause too much trashing. The focus of the team on the sprint goal will not be there if you can let them just change the sprint goal. They will go in multiple directions. The product owner, when writing the stories, will really not care about writing good quality stories, ready stories, because he can just change the sprint goal during a sprint. Commitment of a team will not have any value behind that, because even though they committed to do a certain goal prior to the start of a sprint, during the sprint planning, they can just change the goal within a sprint. Commitment doesn't have any value. The product owner can just decide whatever he wants during a sprint. The team can do whatever they want. There's no focus whatsoever. That's the reason why you shouldn't be changing the sprint goal within a sprint. But you know, when we work with Scrum, it sometimes gets a little bit messy. We can make exceptions, because at the end of the day, Scrum should be serving the business. Because if Scrum doesn't serve the business will not support the use of Scrum in the organization. Really key win-win situation for everyone. That's why we should be making exceptions. But always keep a Scrum guide and the rules in mind when making these exceptions. Let's look at a few scenarios. First, the team has completed all the items of a sprint backlog prior to the end of a sprint. The sprint goal has been reached. Everyone is super happy. What do we do? Well, I would say that the product owner can just pick a little item from the product backlog and move it to the sprint backlog. An item that is guaranteed to be completed. Not a huge item that will start now and then complete in the next sprint. Nope. An item, a small item that is guaranteed to be completed by the team within the sprint. This can be done. I don't feel that it's not as per the Scrum guide, but we should be able to do that. Another example here is when the product owner realizes when the sprint has already started, that an item needs to be deprioritized, removed from the sprint. We no longer need to work on that. And another item needs to be added to the sprint, super high priority. You can just do a swapping. You can just swap these two items. There's a rule for that. For the item that enters the sprint backlog should be the same size or smaller than the items or item leaving the sprint backlog. We are not committing to more work here. Equal work or less work. And last scenario, if a product owner realizes within a sprint that the sprint goal no longer makes any sense, the product owner can decide to terminate the sprint and start a new sprint. Do a planning and start a new sprint with the remaining time that we had until the previously terminated sprint ends. We can do that. Don't ask me how to do that. In all these years as a Scrum Master, as an Agile coach, never did that. So if you did that in the past, if this scenario ever happened to you in the past, please leave down a comment. I'm really interested to know how you handle that. If you want more tips, insights on Agile, Scrum, personal growth, click on the video that stands out the most on the screen right now, and I'll see you in a few seconds.